Hey you, and welcome. I'm Mr. Barry, and this whole video we want to talk about Chrome OS flags. What are they and why you should even care about them? We want to show you where they are and how to turn them on and off. And you know what? It's kind of fun playing with these experimental features that haven't made it to the stable channel of the Chrome OS. So let's take a look at these, you and I. Come on. So this all leads up to the question, what if you turn on all of the flags within the Chrome OS? So let's give it a try right now before we do anything else and just see what would happen if I turn everything on. Here we are in my Chromebook. To find the flags, open up a browser window and then go up to the address box and key in Chrome:// flags. And then hit the enter key once, and it will open up a window as we see here. And this now will lead to the disclaimer. These are experiments. So warning, these are experimental features ahead. By enabling these features, you could lose browser data or compromise your security or privacy. Enabled features apply to all users of this browser. If you are an enterprise admin, you should not be using these flags in production. Now, with that said, if you do notice, there are some very important tools at the very top of this screen. One is the reset all. That's right, if you turn some of these on and they just really muck up your system so it makes it unusable, all you need to do is click on the reset all button found at the very top of this page. Now, it is possible to muck up your system so bad that it doesn't even get to this page. It won't allow you to. Everything just kind of like is in a continuous loop. If that ever happens, Chrome actually detects this and it will automatically reset all of your flags back to default. Now, I am going to go over some of these flags, some that you should never turn on, and a few that will actually, you'll find very helpful. So let me go in, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to be turning on all of the flags, as in 100% of these flags, which I don't recommend anyone doing ever, but I'm just going to do that to see what happens. So as I'm clicking away here at these thousands of flags, let's find out what Chrome flags actually are. They are a way to activate browser features that are not available by default. Many of these features are unstable or very much on the experimental stage there, and that's why it's not recommended that you do this to your work machine or during work hours, because you might have problems with some of these.
Many, many minutes later.
Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on restart, and the system should restart, and we'll see what happens. Well, obviously it didn't work. So I don't recommend turning all of them on. So which ones should you turn on? Let me demonstrate. So let's get back into the flags window here. And notice there's a search box at the very top. I'm going to click up there to search for these items. The very first item I'm going to look for is Show Autofill Predictions. Now this flag shows Chrome autofill predictions as placeholder text in online forms. So when you come up to a sign-up form or other type of form within Chrome, Chrome will offer you an autofill to save you typing the same email address, name, and zip code a zillion times. This flag means as soon as the form opens up, it's auto-populated without you having to type a thing. So we'll enable it here. Now the next one we're going to find is parallel downloading. Now, parallel downloading creates three separate download jobs to accelerate the downloading of very large files. Enabling this flag can make downloads of large files much faster. And what we'll do is we'll click on the default there and then click on enable. Now, the next one we're going to enable is called Quick, Q-U-I-C. Now, in most cases, fast isn't secure and vice versa. Even the very best of the VPNs can slow things down. But Google has been working on a new protocol that combines the elements of TCP and UDP that's both faster and more secure. Now, Quick Protocol works by reducing the number of connection request required to establish a secure connection with the server. So you can enable this one. So after enabling these, you can go ahead and click on the blue restart button found at the bottom of the screen. The system will restart and you'll have those flags now working in the background for you. Now I'm going to be going over two flags that you want to avoid at all costs. The very first one there is zero copy rasterizer. If you enable this, the raster threads will write directly to the GPU memory associated with tiles. That may sound great, and Chrome will work faster, but it is also not very great in that Chrome will now crash very often. So do not enable this flag because it makes the Chrome very unstable. And the next one is site isolation opt out. This disables site isolations, which are intended to keep you safe. So if you enable this, basically you're now unsecure. So by all means, you never want to enable this. So if you're having issues with any of these, you can always click on that reset all button there at the very top of the screen. That will reset all of the flags to being default. Now, why is that important? You say, well, can I just go in and disable what I enabled? Well, if you go in there, you'll notice that on some of the flags, they have more than two options. Some of them have four or more options. And so it's really hard to choose, like, well, which one was the one before? So it's best just to go in and say, reset all if you are experiencing an unstable machine. Now, on a final note, for those who really like to play around with the different channels of Chrome, such as the dev channel or the beta channel or even the canary channel of Chrome, these flags work the same across the board. And to get into it, remember, you just go to chrome:// flags. It's going to look the same across all the channels. Now, will you find the exact same flags on all the channels? The answer is no. Canary beta will have a few extra and your stable version will may not have all of them. So just have that in mind if you're bouncing across different channels, that they're all going to work the same way, but you're not going to have the same flags available in all the channels. So guys, that's it for this session here. Hey, if you like these types of videos, please click on that thumbs up. Comment down below if you have an idea for a future video. And this goes to a big thank you to the one subscriber who said, hey, won't you try to enable all the flags on your Chromebook and see what happens? So thank you very much there. We're able to do that. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and enjoy my other videos there on technology there or on other topics there. Alrighty, thank you again and you all have a very good day. Bye-bye.